Dear friends, let us start with your 11th chapter, that is perimeter and area. Right, now as you know, there are two figures, square and rectangle, which are two dimensional figure, each figure consisting of two dimensions. Now let us consider one by one what is square and what is rectangle. See, this is a square and this is a rectangle. What is square? Square is a quadrilateral. It is a quadrilateral in which all the sides are equal. So here, if you see, all the sides are equal, that is shown by this mark here, here, with side A. A is the magnitude of each side. As you see, this it is a square of side A. Then what is the perimeter of square? As you know, perimeter is nothing but boundary. So perimeter is boundary. If you try to calculate the boundary of this square, you will get A plus A plus A plus A, means A plus A plus A plus A, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 times A. So 4 times A is the perimeter of the square. So if you are having any square, you can calculate the perimeter of that square by knowing the side of that square. If you know the side of square, you can easily multiply the side with 4, you will get the perimeter of square. Now, what is the area of square? As you know, area is the space occupied, right? So area of square is A into A, that is A square. Okay, we will see this in detail. If you multiply these two dimensions, you will get the area of that figure. So A into A is your square, area of square. So A square is the area of square. Now, what is rectangle? Rectangle is again a quadrilateral in which the two dimensions are length and breadth, right? Now here, if you try to calculate the perimeter of rectangle, as you know, rectangle opposite sides are equal. So this is length, this is also length. If this is breadth, this is also breadth. Now what will be the perimeter of this rectangle? Perimeter is nothing but the addition of all the sides, or you can say the boundary of that particular figure. Now boundary of that particular figure is this L plus B plus L plus B. So L plus B plus L plus B, that is 1, 2, 2L, 1, 2, 2B. So 2L plus 2B. Now if you take 2 common from each, you will get L plus B in bracket multiply by 2. So 2 times L plus B is the perimeter of rectangle. Now area of rectangle, again multiply these two dimensions, L and B, you will get L into B as the area of rectangle. Now let us see this perimeter and area in more practical, right? So for that, we have to consider the following examples. Now, what is the perimeter of square ABCD? As you see, this is a square ABCD with side of square is equal to 3 cm. Now, if this is 3 cm, this is 3 cm, this is also 3 cm, and this is also 3 cm. Since it is a square, all sides are equal. Therefore, each side is of 3 cm. If you take a rope and if you try to cover the boundary of this particular square, how much rope will you require? That is 3 cm plus 3 cm plus 3 cm plus 3 cm, that is 12 cm. So perimeter of square ABCD is nothing but the addition of all the sides, that is AB plus BC plus CD plus AD, that is equal to 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3. 3 plus 3, 6, 6 plus 3, 9, 9 plus 3, 12. Or you can directly write 3 into 4, that is equal to 12, because 4 times 3, right? So here you can directly write this 3 into 4, or you can add each side, you will get the same answer. Because as you know, the perimeter of square is given by the formula 4a, and here a is 3. So 4a means 4 into a, 4 into 3, right? That is 12. This way you can calculate the perimeter of square. Now, area of square. What is the area of square? As you see here, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3. Again, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3. You can see here, what is the area of that square? This is a square of 1 centimeter by 1 centimeter, that is 1 centimeter square. How much such squares are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So area of square ABCD is 9 centimeter square. Rather, we can use the formula. Area of square is equal to A square, that is equal to A into A, that is equal to 3 into 3. Because A is equal to 3 here, this is A. So 3 into 3, that is 9 centimeter square. Since here A is 3 centimeter and again A is 3 centimeter. So centimeter into centimeter will gives you centimeter square. Right? So in this way, in the area, you can multiply the dimensions also. Units also. So centimeter into centimeter is centimeter square. Right? And the perimeter has unit equivalent to length, because perimeter is nothing but the length of that particular square and area is nothing but the space occupied. Hence, perimeter has a unit of centimeter and area has a unit of centimeter square. Thank you.